Hello students, today we are going to start 11th part of chapter 12. Nomenclature for di and polyfunctional aromatic compounds. In the last video we have done nomenclature for polyfunctional aliphatic compounds. First point, when an aromatic compound contains two or more functional group, then it is named as derivative of compound with the principal functional group at position 1. Starting from the first example on the left hand side, benzene ring is substituted by COOH and NO2. You have to give preference to COOH carboxylic group, and NO2 will be named as nitro. Then its position will be 4. First position will be for COOH. Then it will be 4-nitrobenzoic acid. Point number 2. If all the functional groups present in the benzene ring, they are such that they are nominally, they belong to the same group, then they are ordered alphabetical. For example, there are two substituents, bromo and chloro. So, according to alphabetical, B comes first. So, B means bromo. It will be given position 1 and will be written at first. 1-bromo-3-iodobenzene. Stereoisomerism. It's an important question of back exercise also. And same example I have quoted here. Isomers which have same structure formula but have different relative arrangement or atoms or groups in space are called stereoisomers, and phenomena is called stereoisomerism. Cis and trans isomerism is an example of stereoisomerism. Here example of but-2-ene. Let us try to understand what is cis-but-2-ene and what is trans-but-2-ene. Cis means on the adjacent position. Same groups on the adjacent position. For this case, we are taking the same group means CH3 group. When both of the CH3, they are on the adjacent side, means at position 1 and 4 on in the left hand side, then it is cis. And again, they are at the position 1 and 4 but in the opposite side. Then it is called trans. Due to pi bonding between the two carbon atoms, the rotation around carbon-carbon double bond is prohibited. And hence, the geometry of atom or groups attached to the carbon atom gets fixed in space. Stereoisomerism is also called geometrical isomerism. Now, what is steric hindrance? If two non bonded atoms or groups in an organic molecule are held together at a distance equal to or less than the sum of their van der Waal radii, then they repel each other due to spatial crowding. This repulsion is referred to as steric hindrance or steric strain. Molecules which possess steric strain are relatively less stable as compared to those having no steric strain. For example, cis-but-2-ene has steric hindrance and hence is less stable as compared to trans-but-2-ene, which has no steric hindrance. As the size of atoms around a bulky atom increases, the steric hindrance increases accordingly. Nucleophiles and electrophiles. In an organic reaction, the organic compound called the substrate reacts with a suitable attacking species called the reagent to form products. The formation of products may occur either directly from the reactants through a transition state or through the formation of one or more intermediates. Sometimes byproducts are also formed from intermediates. For example, organic molecule, they first give intermediates. Then these intermediates give products and byproducts. Substrate is that reactant which supplies carbon for the formation of a new bond, while the other reactant is called the reagent. A sequential account of each step describing details of electron movement, energetic during bond cleavage and bond formation, and the rates of transformation of reactants into products is called reaction mechanism. Electrophiles are electron loving chemical species. Their attraction for electrons is due to presence of an electron deficient atom in them. Electrophiles may be either positively charged or electrically neutral chemical species. Now, what are positive electrophiles? H positive, Cl positive, Br positive, I positive, NO2 positive, and O positive are positive. Now, what are neutral electrophiles? R free radical, Cr2, SO3, BF3, AlCl3, FeCl3, SnCl4. Since both positively charged and neutral electrophiles are short by a pair of electrons, they have a strong tendency to attract electrons from other sources and hence behave as Lewis acids. Electrophiles always attack the substrate molecule at the site of highest electron density. All the positively charged species do not always act as electrophiles. Only those positively charged species which can accept a pair of electron can act as electrophiles. Thus, NH4 positive, Na positive, Ca+2 cannot act as electrophiles, since all of these already have an octet of electron in their respective valence shells. Nucleophiles are nucleus loving chemical species. Since the nucleus of any atom is positively charged, therefore nucleophiles must be electron-rich chemical species containing at least one lone pair of electrons. There may be either negatively charged or neutral chemical species. Negative nucleophiles H negative, BH4 negative, AlH4 negative, Cl negative, Br negative, etc. Neutral nucleophiles H2O, NH3, RNH2, etc. Both negatively charged and neutral nucleophiles contain at least one unshared pair of electrons and they are called Lewis bases. Nucleophiles always attack the substrate molecule at the site of lowest electron density.